So, first of all, congrats for being back.
Thank you. Back. Very happy.
We're at 10 episodes now.
Yeah.
Now, as we go to season 2, and you know, one of the things that was so great about it was, you know, the relationship between Andy and Peggy. Now that they're together in a big old Hollywood, what can you tease about their relationship as, you know, like, do you see them as sisters as well? Like, you know, is it that relationship? And what can you, like, tease about them this season?
I love them in the first season together. I thought they had a wonderful kind of friendship, and it was really great to explore that. We hope that we will be able to see them together, and the fact is we don't know that they can take them.
I was actually going to say the relationship I look for in Agent Carter was actually Peggy and Jarvis. I thought that their rapport and the banter that they had was amazing, and I'm very glad that he got listed as a series regular. So please
their
tell
relationship, yes,
they're amazing.
The core, quickly learned it was the heart of the show.
Yes, absolutely.
So the nice thing about moving into LA is there's a really organic way to include Jarvis by using Howard Sharp. So Howard was saying moved to LA because that's where the tech industry is starting up, like, you know, the atomic industry is starting up. So they all do some contract work with our friends, and then I'll open up a movie studio. Jacksonville. So Jarvis is there setting up his estate in Beverly Hills, which is like a Playboy mansion meets Neverland with like flamingos and chicks in bikinis. Because, yeah, I'm with you. It's like that. As soon as we saw them together, we're like, let's try and do that as much as we can. It has changed. In maybe an unexpected way, I think we'll find that Bear, who's in a sort of an unexpected place when we start the story, I think, and there's some unresolved things between those two that are going to come out.
So, I mean, with the Hollywood move and everything like that, is that a way that you can do that? Is it another way that feminism kind of looked at them, or like how someone who is that strong and powerful operates under a completely weirdly different guise of, you know, expectations?
Well, I definitely, I feel like it inadvertently, feminism has, we didn't plan to do a show about feminism, but it naturally kind of came, worked its way into the storyline, and there are different ways that we're going to explore that in the second season.
There's probably not going to be a lot of signaling, I assume. The Peggy story and Peggy getting flippant about that would be told, but it's not that 1947 and sexism no longer exists. Great. But it will just tell.
But I think that we show different perspectives of back then how women used their power.
Yeah.
Well, thank you guys so much.
Can you do the radio voice quickly?
No.